Good morning from London and welcome to a new day of fun.
It's early morning and here in London it's cold. It's frost on the ground. We're in Hyde Park. This is one big park. However, we call it Hyde Park. And I'm not sure if Hyde Park refers to the entirety of the park, but this section here is called Kensington Garden. So I'll have to research when we get home and see if the whole thing is Hyde Park or if there's two parks in one. But technicality is, it's one big park. In one of our last videos in Seattle, Myrtle Edward Park, if you haven't seen it, please check it out. We show a couple, it's freezing weather in Seattle, and we show a couple people, or two or three people, running in shorts, and I thought these people here in Seattle are crazy, but thing is people here in London are doing the same thing. Didn't plan that, but you see what I'm talking about? It's freezing, literally freezing.
Very cold.
And that's not the first person we've seen running in shorts. So, I guess it's not the people of Seattle that are crazy, it's just runners in general. No matter where at in the world they're at, Seattle, London, runners are crazy.
I can't believe how friendly they are.
We're now what they call the orangery.
And in the falafel, it's falafel and eggplants, right?
Yeah. I don't know what to eat.
We're at Princess Diana Memorial Playground and we're having breakfast. What you eating?
It's a tuna mayo with cucumbers.
And I'm having a tomato and mozzarella. We'd call it a grilled cheese. I guess here they call it a toasty. Mm-hmm. How was your sandwich?
Very good. Very, very good.
So I had a tomato and cheese toasty, grilled cheese, I guess you'd say. I have to say it's probably one of the best things I've eaten here in London. So, moral of the story is, don't underestimate street food that you find in the park. Because sometimes it can be really good. Subway ride on our way to the Tower of London.
We are at Tower Hill.
No, we're not.
Yeah?
No, we're not. Tower Hill.
Tower Hill. Yeah, that's Tower Hill.
Underground station.
Station. Tower Hill. That's the one. We're gonna see the Tower of London. This is the football field when the queen is bored of so much politics. She comes here and she plays football. This is the predecessors. Yeah, that's the map. And as usual, you cannot see much.
You don't know about time butcher. And unfortunately for the Duke of Monmouth, he was a full-time drunk as well. And on that day in question, for some reason, Jack decided to bring all them skills together at once. And he required 5 swipes of the axe to sever the head from the body. And then it wasn't over. He had to kneel down in his drunken stupor Take out his butcher's carving knife to cut through that final piece of flesh, that last bit of sinew and bone, before he could separate that head from the body. And then he held it aloft with all that blood and all that gore running down his arm. And he proclaimed, "Behold, this is the head of a traitor. So die all traitors. God save the king."
We're at the London Tower. We just got a Queen Elizabeth 90th anniversary commemorative souvenir coin. Got to our collection of souvenir coins. We should do a video where we just go through and show off of our coins.
Oh yeah, we should.
That'd be cool.
That would be nice.
Collected a lot of coins.
Let's go directly to this one first.
Where you want to go?
This one first, in the middle. So I have to go through here. And
So if someone is pleasing to look at, they are more likely to be a good person. Some people say.
Yes. Indeed.
Though that's not always borne out, is it?
No, good looks can be sold. They can.
And dismiss the powerful supporters from positions of power, none know the refuge they hope for.
Tradition says that King Henry was murdered here in this room in 1471 while he was praying in the chapel.
The tower had played a crucial part in that victory. It was a different story to me.
Next, I wanted to...
It was demolished in 1770 and rebuilt in the 19th century, so this is a rebuild, modern rebuild.
Imagine me in here.
If you can.
Good morning, how are you?
Not well. Been locked up in the tip tower for quite a few years. Sick of it, I'll be honest with you. But how are you? More to the point. Are you well?
Good, thank you.
Good, excellent. I can't abide being in that room any longer. This is the salt tower. If you wish to step within, you're most welcome to do so.
What did you do to get thrown in there?
I was the King of Scotland, sir.
Oh.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Hardly seems fair, does it?
Bad news in England.
Well, I was elected by the English to rule over Scotland. I have lands in Scotland and in England. I'm an English lord as well as a Scottish one. But things have soured in the politics between our lands over the last 10 years or so. And unfortunately, I've been declared traitorous to my... Lord Edward Longshanks, as he is nicknamed by many. Very tall man, very tall man. But by this year of 1299, the English now have the upper hand again, so I don't think I will ever be released. They have fought the Battle of Falkirk last year and utterly crushed my countrymen. So I am sick to death of the whole business, if truth be told. I would happily go away to the continent and live without any dealings with the English or the Scottish ever again. Most of my own lords turn against me. Most of the Scots hate my guts just as much as the English do. It's a nightmare.
We just met the King of Scotland from 1299.
Yes.
What was his name again? John?
John? I don't know. We asked him, but I forgot his name.
We'll look it up on the internet.
This is very narrow.
Picking up the shard. That's pretty whited out. Oh, there's the shard. So behind us you can see the shard, which just is really beautiful about London, is there's such a blend of new, modern, and old and historic. Like over here, from the London Tower, you see the modern downtown, little egg-shaped building. I wonder if you can find the there's a cell phone.
There's a
cell phone tower.
We're gonna see Mihaela jewels. Oh, sorry, crown jewels.
Just use the royal toilet.
But only in the top. The line of kings has changed many times. Around 1692, some of the arms and armor stored in the White Tower was used to create a famous display, the line of kings. Dragon.
That's Mihaela.
Oh.
If Mihaela says she wants shoes and you tell her no, this is what she turns into. $215.
Oh, it is difficult.
The other arm.
this one?
Yeah, the other arm.
Like this?
No.
Like this?
No, the other, the right hand, but the other way.
Oh, this
no,
one?
No, no, no. Your right hand.
This way?
Yes. No, no.
I don't know.
Like this.
Ah, okay.
There you go. Okay, stop. You got farther than me.
It's difficult. Put it up a little bit.
Whoa.
I break. Hello.
Well, that's it for the White Tower.
Anne Boleyn was imprisoned in this tower. Henriette and Anne Boleyn marriage ended up right here. She was sent to prison and afterwards she was sent to death.
So having watched the Showtime series, The Tudors, it was a big pleasure to go in this tower. This is where Anne Boleyn was imprisoned before her head was chopped off.
And later on, Elizabeth I, her daughter, was imprisoned in the same tower. And afterwards, of course, her head was chopped off.
No, she became queen.
Yeah, yeah, after she became
Elizabeth
queen.
Queen. Oh,
Elizabeth I, Anne Boleyn's daughter.
She became queen.
Yeah, she became queen.
She, her head wasn't chopped off.
Wasn't?
She's giving you false history, people. Don't listen to her.
Google it.
False history. False history.
What is it in the Bloody Tower?
Open and have a look, sweetie.
All right, let's go. Pop in and have a look, sweetie. Pop in and have a look, sweetie.
Very narrow. We are in the torture tower.
This was email back in the day.
Name myself Quinn.
Well, there's the moat. The grass moat. Well, that's it for the London Tower. I have to say that we almost didn't come. We had decided to take this off of the list of things to see. But I'm so glad we changed our mind because it's definitely on the top of my list for the things that we've done here in London. You know, it just makes me think in life, there's so many good ideas that we want to write off or think are stupid. So many businesses that I've heard of people started and I think, wow, what a dumb idea. But they're millionaires, they're very successful. You know, even with our small and insignificant YouTube channel at this point, our most successful video so far wasn't even intended to be put up. Mihaela just painted it, not with the intention of posting it, but just as a practice for some idea she had. And I saw it and I said, oh, I'm not going to put that up. Exactly. And then we didn't have anything to put up, so I said, okay, let's use this. We put it up. And it's the best performing video so far. So I guess the lesson in life is, I guess think twice about your ideas that you think are stupid or you're ready to throw away, because they might just turn out to be your best ideas.